Students, welcome back to our class. That is retail marketing and retail management. Today we are going to learn. We are in third unit in between. So our today's topic is retail banking. Before it was used to take by Saipasasa, and now it's me Azam sir. I'm going to continue with this session. Retail bank. What do you mean by retail banking? Retail banking is also known as consumer banking or personal banking or banking that provides financial services to individual consumers rather than business. So services offered by retail banks include checking and savings accounts, mortgages, personal loans, credit cards, certificate of deposits. All these things are there. So the economic reform have brought major changes in the banking services, because of which retail banking has undergone changes from the sellers to the buyers market. The lifestyle of Indian consumer is changing due to the changes in the consumption and income patterns of the household. So all this holds a drastic impact on the banking habits of Indians, leading to the growth of retail banking in the present scenario. So what does it mean? It means that the corporates nowadays are generating funds and financial resources from the debt market and commercial papers by passing the banks. Banks must focus on medium-sized entrepreneurs for their survival in business. Now, types of retail bank. How many types of retail banking are there? Broadly speaking, I am saying frankly, it's very important that there are main three retail bank system, that is commercial system and commercial bank, credit unions and certain investment funds. So its specialized is management by odds, recapitalization, generalization, transition, acquisition, add-on acquisition, growth, equity and leverage layouts. These are the main terms of retail banking. Retail banking consists of personal banking, business banking, international banking, corporate banking. Now, what are the functions of retail banking? Before going for the functions of retail banking, our other thing is retail banking and banks are required to redesign their business model to deliver products in a highly dynamic market, establish multiple delivery channels for controlling the cost of operations, maintain collaborative relationship with the provides finance products and services, convert the network of bank branches into financial supermarkets. Now, we'll go for the functions of retail banking. See, the retail banking main functions are to provide finance services for individuals and families. That means to provide the financial services for individuals or for families or organizations. The three most important functions are, it will provide the credit, deposit and money management. The first, retail banks offer consumers credit to purchase homes, cars and furniture. Then they can deposit. That means the consumer should have to deposit the money and their company can make a good money. Now, what are the recent trends in banking? The thing is, we are having four terms. That means retail banking has witnessed the following trends. What are those? Multi-channel distribution, call centers, support services, technology, and last one is rural exposure. Now, multi-channel distribution, it means it refers to a type of distribution which involves the delivery of services to the customers through different channels such as ATMs, telephone, internet, etc. Then, cost and technology plays a crucial role in designing channels. Due to the emergence of competition, consumers want quality products and services at low cost and more conveniently of their doorsteps, forcing the banks to establish new delivery channels. So, the main purpose of retail banking is to provide highly differentiated channels for the distribution and the delivering of multiple products. Then call center supports. The call center supports are nothing but for maintaining close relationship with customer banks or supporting the sales and services functioned by the establishment of call centers. Not only that, they have lost that means efficiency as it means they have lost their efficiency as it uses the same model since its inception. So the customers are getting irritated due to the queuing up of calls, causing an increase in the waiting time for providing the services. So there are call centers, customer services, and are providing maintenance customer interactions. The establishment of such call centers services were highly appreciated at the time of its inception, but now it is not acceptable. Technology. The public and private players are tech-savvy. Technology lies between the cutting edge among banks and for the real product differentiation. So by focusing on technological innovations, banks take advantage of the retail banking ventures by penetrating into the new areas of cross-selling their products of various channels. Last one is rural exposure. So rural areas of India needs to provide infrastructure assistance for retail banking. So the recommendation of Narasimhan Committee of 1991 has shown a drastic change in the banking sector. So it has suggested government for all establishment of a stable financial system which is found to be unique to the Indian economy. Thus, retail banking provides various diversification and growth opportunities to the foreign players and allowing them to enter the banking sector. Next one. Mutual funds. See, the mutual funds are nothing but everyone are aware of these things. What are those? People know what we are having here. Four phases. If you want to see here, the first one is 1, 2, 3, 4, and the fifth one has been gone. But here, according to our syllabus, first phase started 1964 to 1987, second one 1987 to 1992, phase two 1992 to 1997, and again phase four 1997 to 2014. Now it is phase five. Phase 5 concept November, that means 2014 to till now. Okay. Now, this is one more of mutual funds AMU growth, how it is taking place. So now we will go one by one, what does it include and what are the things are going. Like, in the phase 1, see, the concept of mutual funds emerged with the establishment of UTI, that means Unit Trust of India, in 1963 and was considered the first mutual establishment under UTI Act 1962, a special act of the parliament. It commenced its operations in 1964 with the objective of mobilizing, saving and gaining or investing with them with the help of corporate securities in order to achieve maximizing yield and capital appreciation. Phase 2 started with the entry of the mutual fund, which is sponsored by nationalized banks and insurance companies. So during the year 1987, the two funds launched in India Trust Act at 1882 are SBI Mutual Fund and Canara Bank Mutual Fund in 1988. So the UTI, the Unit Trust of India, launched another fund called the India Growth Fund, and this fund is listed on the New York Stock Exchange, NYSE. Coming to the third phase, the history of mutual funds changed during the year 1993, and during this year, the Securities and Exchange Board of India, SEBI, Security and Exchange Board of India, in 1990, issued a mutual fund regulations. The common regulatory framework of SEBI notified regulations for all mutual funds except UTI. Coming to the phase 4, this has been steadily increasing the flow of the funds towards mutual funds. This phase has a positive impact on capital market, tax benefits, and improvement in the quality of investor service. In the year 1999 to 2000, sales mobilization level increased significantly from 31,420 crore to 73,000 crore. Imagine how the improvement has been taken. Now, we will go to the next thing. What are the top most insurance trends emerging in 2016? The first one is it increased usage of Internet of Things and acquiring big data. See, usage of increasing, usage of Internet of Things is nothing but that we're using Internet of Things for many reasons, such as identification of risks or customer requirements, low cost of sensors, etc. Acquiring big data is nothing but sources such as social media and gathering insights and information for claiming, processing, and fraud detection. Next one is using aerial digital imagery for quick claims processing. Insurers are using aerial and digital imagery for assessing losses and damages of lands or properties. Next one, shift from auto insurance to usage based. See, advanced technologies like GPS, G-force tracking, accelerometer, meters, etc. in smartphones, and telematic systems in cars, vehicles, and other value-added services which are built for customer safety influence the insurers to shift from auto insurance to usage-based insurance. So, with the help of these technologies, insurers can improve their claim handling capabilities and can carry out better customer segmentation. Next, applying gamification process. Then, what is happening in these to deal with the complex process or to improve internal training and to enhance customers' engagement and loyalty, they are using this technique. Then, non-trading firms entering into the insurance industry for the huge customer base, capital availability, and data processing power by entering into the insurance. That the industry in the form of partnership, joint venture, and alliances and acquisition can improve their customers and capital. Then, concept of peer-to-peer insurance. The main concept of peer-to-peer insurance is nothing but to reduces the cost of insurance and makes the uninsured people to buy the insurance policy. The insurance companies may face a tough competition in this model is adopted by majority of firms. Then, faced on mHealth application. What do you mean mHealth application? Medical health. mHealth application is very effective, which controls and improves the customer's health and reduces their spending on healthcare. So, therefore, the insurers are emphasizing on mHealth app, which enables them to understand the customer's risk profile. Last, increased demand for cyber insurance. So, this nowadays the technology is creating to protect themselves from cyber attacks. And demand for cyber insurance and increasing nowadays. So these are the trends why the most insurance are taking place. Now if you talk about the some more apart from understand, these are the things that like sharing economy, insurance distribution refined, value chain disaggregation, augmented reality, Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, blockchain, advanced analytical, value added services, innovative digital and mobile offering. These are the market dynamic, nascent, and customer preferences. So these are the things which are creating importance in the retail banking. So I hope students understand the concept, and please mention your own numbers in the comment box. Thank you.